Good morning, and happy Great Enlightenment Day. My name is Patty Daniel, my Dharma name is Wan Unhewa, and I'm here to talk today about what enlightenment means to me. My strongest association with that word comes straight out of my Western cultural heritage and what I learned about the Age of Enlightenment, also known as the Age of Reason, which, as you know, was an intellectual and philosophical movement preceded by the scientific revolution and which dominated the world of ideas in Europe during the 17th and 18th centuries. That concept of enlightenment was centered on the pursuit of happiness, the sovereignty of reason, and the evidence of the physical senses, the realm of phenomena, as the primary source of knowledge and ideals. I find that use of the word enlightenment rather thrilling, contrasted as it was in my high school and college classes with what preceded it, the Dark Ages, a time of cruelty, exploitation of the masses by monarchies, and rampant superstition. As far as I was concerned, all the mysteries of the universe could be, or already had been, explained by science. But Buddhism introduced me to a new concept of enlightenment, one not so thrilling, and in fact, downright difficult. Wan Buddhism in particular taught me that enlightenment is being awakened to the ultimate truth of Ilwan Song, a realm beyond words and speech. It urged me to understand, to see without eyes, the world of non-duality and the essential emptiness of our true nature. What was I to do with that? I was taught that our founding teacher, Master Soto-san, was himself enlightened, and I thought, how could anyone possibly know that? I wondered if it was possible to be a little bit enlightened, but decided that was probably like being a little bit pregnant. I thought that ordinary human wisdom could be cultivated, and that in itself was enough. After all, having also been taught that desire, craving, and attachment are the sources of our misery, I concluded that an attachment to enlightenment would therefore be problematic. I found the whole concept rather mystical and therefore troubling. Still do, in fact. Lately, however, I have mostly managed to put all that to rest. I now think I wasn't asking the right questions. I think I may have been asking the questions to which I already had the answers. Nowadays, I try to focus on the big picture. I try not to pin down the concept of enlightenment with logic and reason. Rather, I try to keep it, whatever it is, in the back of my mind and go about my daily practice with as much sincerity and dedication as I can muster. The path we are all on is said to be the path to enlightenment, and Wan Buddhism is somewhat unique in encouraging us all to aspire to enlightenment in this lifetime. If I just stay on the path, perhaps enlightenment will somehow unfold, perhaps not. But regardless, the journey continues. Thank you.